Hey, welcome to the, I can't even remember what show it was there, the Sixth and Show, episode 5. I'm Fly Guy from FlyGuy.net, joined as always by Matt from, in fact, Toy Tribe, and also Matt from Star Wars, Instagram.com, Instagram.com/Star Wars The Black Series. It's late for us, but how are you doing, man?
Yeah, no, I'm doing good. I'm doing good. Just not sure which page I'm from tonight, but I'm from many.
It's late for us people that are watching, but we're glad you joined and thank you for joining yet again. We had nearly 1,000 people are watching roughly each episode, so thank you. It's like tons of people. It's fantastic. And really, really nice comments. So just a little quick shout out to some of the people, a lot of questions and great stories and people responding with all sorts of questions and stuff. And it's really, really nice. I saw you get some on your Instagram page as well. There was people saying some very nice things about it. So thank you, everybody.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Starismatone had some stuff, and thank you again for your nice comments. Again, he was sharing some stuff about some prices in the UK and other places. We've had people sharing prices from Germany, from the UK, Canada, all across the US and Australia as well. So jump into the comments under the video and let us know what you're thinking, what you think of the show, toys you want to collect, and any stuff we'll go through tonight. So thank you everyone who dropped a comment and questions. I've pretty much went through and tried to answer everybody today, so appreciate it. Lots and lots of comments. So episode 5, we've got some news for you. We've got, as usual, all the stuff from Matt's page, Instagram.com/Star Wars The Black Series. We're going to go over some of that cool stuff that he's got too. We'll look again at part 2 of the Black Series kind of history. We'll go back and look at the next or the second wave of figures and talk about them. And that's pretty much it. Some Marvel Legends and other stuff, but let's get fired right into it. And the very first link we've got to talk about tonight is some news, some Star Wars reveals and stuff out there. Some terrible photographs, it has to be said, but I'm sure you saw this, man. Jedi Temple Archives shared earlier on this week. A little target spy had found, I believe it's the First Order Incinerator Trooper, I think it was. I can't remember the guy's name. Yeah, that's the Judicial, that's what it is. So this guy here, this, hopefully you can see my screen, yes?
Yep,
cool. So two figures there, which I did not know about. I don't know whether you did or not, but this Judicial Trooper here, he comes with these little... we've seen little leak shots of this, a little black paint on his helmet, and a little different pauldron, and this kind of weird-looking kind of weapon, which we'll see more of soon. And another Black Series look, basically the same one which we're getting, I believe, the best people and rumors are telling us, but with this little piece of environment, basically the end of The Force Awakens. Did you see this?
Yeah, I did.
What do you think?
I don't know, I like the little environmental rock. It's something different. I imagine this is a bit like the the Kylo and the Rey Starkiller base explosive. Yep. I'm sure it'll be a square box.
Yeah.
Maybe this one will come with a lightsaber. Like third time lucky,
yeah,
or something.
I know he still hasn't got one, but it's just weird. There's nothing on the base. I thought it was gonna be one of these environment dioramic pieces which we've had before, the Hoth and the Tantive 4-pack, but this seems like a lump of grass and rock. But I'm not complaining, because it'll be great for loads of different figures, and get Luke off that thing. I want troopers on that thing, but don't you think?
Look, it'll also lend itself to some toy photography. People can set it up and cheat some shots and kind of get that Force Awakens shot going. But, you know, my assumption is that if this is one that we're seeing now, maybe there's another one or two of Rey training, or
good point,
Kylo turning up, or who knows what joins to it or goes with it.
Kind of weird. I mean, that's three Luke Skywalkers in an incredibly tight time frame.
Making up for 2 years of no Luke Skywalkers.
Yeah, but I think this might make Luke a little peg warmery, but don't know. We'll see. We'll find it. So $29.99 at Target, I believe. $19.99 for the Judicial Trooper. Again, links in the show notes under the description in YouTube. So, yeah, that was kind of interesting. Kind of fun to see something new. But yet again, Force Friday is nearly upon us, and Hasbro have just, they're literally telling us nothing. So, yep, leave it up to everybody to leak stuff. One thing that wasn't leaked, Jason at Yakface tweeted this out. He'd seen some pictures on eBay, an eBay seller had pictures of Thrawn and the Landspeeder in hand. We'll just get a bit of a better look at that picture, see if I can blow it up a little bit. So if you haven't seen it, that's the non-San Diego Comic-Con box. That looks pretty good.
I like it a lot.
Yeah, I do, me too. It looks very nice indeed. Love that kind of zooming in and out the box. That's very nice. Lots of different shots on it. Kind of like a little schematic going on up at the top up there and a little window. I like it. It's very cool indeed. And we get a box shot of Thrawn. I think we've seen a few leaks before. That art does not look like Thrawn to me, but looks like one of the melty-faced cops out of Deep Space Nine, if anybody knows what I mean. But, don't know about that. Never mind. We know we're getting them, so that's something cool. Nice to see the packaging coming, because, again, Hasbro ain't telling us anything. Some other news this week was, which I'm sure you saw as well, the Darth Vader pack. So a lot of people still really unsure about this, and I got loads of questions of people saying, well, what Vader is this? Is this the one with the removable helmet? No, this is the 40th anniversary legacy pack, repacked again in black and red. So another chance to get Darth
at a much more affordable price.
At a much more affordable price. Although, to be honest, a lot of people this week, and it wasn't really worth adding too much news because it varies on your Walgreens store. But if you were in the US, some Walgreens were having the legacy pack at a disgusting $7.50. Can you believe that? It's just crazy. We pay like $60 here by the time you convert it.
$60, it's even. Oh, yeah, $60 converted.
Pretty much you convert it, yeah, I know. Kind
of Toys R Us have a heap of them on shelves still at $79.
It's nuts, isn't it? It is absolutely nuts. So, yeah, it's the new peg warmer, peeps. But this guy will probably sell out heavily because he's in that black and red pack, which does look awesome with a lightsaber, must admit.
I think this, remember that Revenge of the Sith teaser poster of Anakin Hayden, and it had the cape kind of making Darth Vader's face?
Yes. Yeah, that's a good point. I never thought about that.
Yeah, that's what I see when I see that picture.
Well, funnily enough, someone asked Yakface what we thought about it, and he said dramatic flair, and I replied Sith fart in terms of the cape just fluttering behind them. So you don't know the power of the Sith fart. So there's a loose shot of Vader. Again, if you've not got one now, then, well, you can get in one here. But he's a solid Vader. You got one, didn't you?
Yeah, I got one. I think it's one of the best figures to date.
Yeah, it's pretty good. It's pretty solid. So Vader is coming. Just some package shots of that. And then also some other images leaked out this week. Again, Hasbro are just telling us nothing, sharing nothing. But their retailers and their e-tailers are leaking these things left, right, and center. Amazon in Spain had these images shared out. We'll just blow them up a little bit so you can see them if you're watching us on the screen there. So Kylo Ren looking very strange with that outfit. Quite different. No swap-out helmet. So there's no Kylo metallic black helmet. Just his face with a new cape and a couple of sabers this time. And there's Luke in his new box, exactly the same figure as the SDCC version. There's Rey, exactly the same as the SDCC version, but looking good with lightsaber. And again, yeah, as you pointed out earlier, no lightsaber with Luke. It's a bit measurable, isn't it? Really?
I'm sure it's got something to do. I've just my feeling is that if he doesn't have his green lightsaber, he will use the blue one at some stage, and you know, who knows.
This was another one that was kind of a little bit surprising. Finn first ordered his guys, reusing a bit of Hux, I guess, in some ways, and we get a fully extended Riot Trooper baton, a little pistol we've had before, and removable helmet, if removable hat, I should say. So that kind of, I think that leaked it a little bit about the plot, I guess, giving that kind of release out there. There's loose pictures of Rey looking okay, not looking too bad. I got a blaster from Han Solo and all the staff and bits and pieces. Apparently the staff is a little bit different from the previous one. There's Luke with no lightsaber. And there's Kylo again, just to see the shot. So the cape's looking really different. It looks very much like a kind of a Krennic cape.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of the cape.
No, me neither.
I just thought you know, after the Vader cape, and there must be a lot of excess black material in the factory. I understand the big problem would be, how do they get the cape around the head without some big awful chain? But I think there's a better solution than this heavy plastic.
Yeah, well, one good thing is it'll help him stand up, that's for sure. Yeah, and there's another shot of Finn with his hat kind of tipped off. This has so struck me since we last did this episode about basically saying the people that are posing these photographs are, not to diss them, but they do seem weird. His hat's half off his head.
I know.
It's like, and it's just such a very weird pose. Oh, man. Anyway. So that is some new figures. So I'm looking forward to Carly then. They're not the most exciting. Other, I guess we've seen all these characters apart from Finn in a different outfit, but they seem solid enough. That is... I should have put that into the Marvel Legends section. Let me just move this out there. And paste that in there. Just talk amongst yourselves while I move stuff around. The... Luke X-Wing Deadpool, turned up, Luke X-Wing Deadpool, my God, it's late tonight. The Luke X-Wing pilot turned up on eBay very briefly from an Italian seller. I'm still looking at the wrong page here. There we go. But sold out very quickly, $50 US for one of these X-Wing Luke pilots, which is just, what a steal. Is
that a backup? He sold 11 of them.
Sold 11 of them. Oh my God, it's back up again. He's only get 52 as a rating, so you got to be careful here, folks. Don't know. But, well, we'll find out soon enough. You'll either lose $50 or, yep, you're going to get a great bargain, I guess, considering the damn things cost nearly $50, 45, I think it was, or 40 at the show. Can't remember. So, yes. Yeah, when you compare it to the $339 shipping. Some people are just, there's no shame in just going for like just as much as they could possibly gouge out of people, and stupid people pay it.
I was looking at some Thrawns from, I can't remember where it was, but it was that classic thing of $24 for the Comic-Con exclusive. They had lots of ratings to justify it as a real page, but the shipping was like $96. And it's just it's a commission thing. It's a commission rot. So you don't have to pay your percentage to PayPal if it's on the shipping. So they were low sale price but high shipping.
I thought actually PayPal did do that now. Maybe I was wrong.
I'm not sure. That's the only way I could read it, because I was just like, they're looking at it going, $24 for the figure, but your shipping's at 96 fixed. So who knows?
That is pretty bad. One other thing that has popped up this week, which I didn't know about actually, maybe you did, and maybe you guys did out there. But anyway, we thought we'd share it out with you as well, as 3PO, the Walgreens exclusive, is coming to Entertainment Earth. Did you know about that?
No, but I think I saw... What did I see? I saw it back in its box and I heard it was coming back. I didn't know it was... Is it just Entertainment Earth, or is it going to come back into one of the waves?
Just seems to be Entertainment Earth.
Okay, I did see something that it was coming back. I didn't realize it's an exclusive, a second time exclusive.
Yeah, I thought for a minute this was a typo and this should have been the 40th anniversary. And I thought, well, maybe fair enough if they've got some stock or stocks coming. Or this is definitely not the 40th anniversary. This is the black and red Walgreens exclusive, which is a little odd. Don't know. Kind of weird to have this back here again, but I don't know. We'll see. So that they've got that coming in September if you're interested in picking it up. Also on their site, if you haven't yet picked one up, I didn't realize they still had some available. They did have R2s at one point, single case packs, and that was rumored a little while ago. But the fact that these are now still up, they're still taking pre-orders, and Hasbro then obviously have still got it on their register that they're delivering these in October, which is literally weeks away, you can maybe still grab a Han Solo. I need one. I need to get another one. For $21. So not that bad, although Entertainment Earth charge an arm and a leg to ship if you've ever bought anything from them, I'm sure. Not cheap. But there you go. What else have we got? Star Wars. I think that's pretty much us for Star Wars. Some Marvel Legend news very quickly. Hasbro sent us very kindly the high-res images for Mr. Poole and his X-Force guys. We'll just take a quick look at that. Very weird what they've kind of done here. They've taken a little blast effect from Tony Stark, his recent Marvel Legends figure, sprayed it orange and red, and that's now became a little add-on to a rifle. But otherwise, pretty much everything seems to be identical to the previous release. Did you pick this up? No, did you skip this?
No, I didn't. I haven't got a Deadpool yet.
Criminal.
No, no.
We're not friends anymore. So the it's a great figure, absolutely stunning figure, and I don't blame them for repacking it. It's the rocket launcher we've had before. There's the Tony Stark jet thruster effect, which looks quite nice on there. The last one came with a boxing glove. Tackle, still getting your tackle, getting your two katanas. He's got a really weird, slightly crappy blue blaster. And Hasbro have repacked in a couple of these god-awful blasters. I think they're from a Red Skull figure of old. Knife and what was a silver gun before now gets kind of Deadpoolish colors and his kind of mutated head again. So that's a HasCon exclusive, although I've already seen it on Asian sellers and they're happily selling it already right now. So yeah, there you go. So maybe will you get this one? No, still
no, probably not. If I was gonna get one, it'd be the red one, I think.
I am just a Deadpool sleazebag, so Scott from Tulsa, always a great person to follow on the tweets. Check him out at TulsaScott. He's always finding bargains. He lives in the bargain capital of the world, that man. And as such, he's been telling us that some of the older Marvel Legends on stores there and Walmarts are ringing up for $9 each. The larger, more modern ones still at $20 than the Netflix one, the more modern waves. So older stuff, there's Star-Lord and some of this older stuff here from Captain America. So $9 for Marvel Legends. Pretty good if you're looking to do a Build-A-Figure. Pretty cheap way to finally scurry around and do that. You ever bought any or figures just to get the Build-A-Figure? You don't really do that, do you?
Nah, I haven't had enough of them, and particularly not enough from one wave. So
got to get the Aussie Hulkbuster, man. It's the best version of all the Marvel Legend Hulkbusters. So good. So good, so good. This is kind of unusual. The Hasbro, and I bet this doesn't happen for Star Wars, but the Marvel Legends San Diego Comic-Con exclusives, and that's also including the 12-inch Marvel Legends Deadpool, are still up on Hasbro Toy Shop, and they've been up for like a day. So, and I'm not too surprised. These don't do anything for me personally. You got an Odin son, Lady Jane, Thor, what's that? Thor with a beard, and we've got a version that's come out just now without a beard. And I can't remember that dude's name, the big ugly dude at the end. Rock Trolls. Yeah, this $100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. $20 a figure. They're not bad, but I think they're kinda dull. Do you think?
Yeah, like I think they need one or more two A figures in there or something.
Yeah. That's a good way of putting it. Yep, definitely some A-figures. So, yes, if you still want them on, you can get them. So there you go. No San Diego Comic-Con nonsense.
I guess maybe just a reminder for everyone that the Star Wars figures didn't go up yesterday, that they're coming in September.
A lot of people are freaking out about that. Saying, where's the Star Wars ones? They will be gone in a flash.
Yeah.
They will not last long. There's no packs like Thor up there. So that is pretty much it for most of the tell-a-lie. There's more. Shut up, me. Old boy CTTS, the customizer of choice for many people, doing some nice facial sculpts, and who you've kind of turned me on to, on his Facebook page posted this. He took the, I think his name, I can never pronounce it properly, John Bernthal, the Punisher, and repainted, I believe. Yep, just a straight repaint. But I don't think it's too far a difference this time, but still damn good.
Look, I think they just do. They give a good sculpt, a Hot Toys kind of look.
Yes, they do. They do indeed.
In reality, and that just looks like it's a 12-inch version of the figure, and the one on the left is a good sculpt in its own right for its $20, but...
Yep. They've just improved it. I have to say, it's one of those things that I think once you see it up close, we talked about this already, this facial sculpt technology, and I've just got the Thor Ragnarok wave in yesterday. By God, they are just outstandingly good compared to what we had before. We talked about Jessica Jones and the Netflix wave just being fantastic. But again, the Thor Hulk, I can't remember Kate Blanchett's character, but oh my goodness.
They are just,
thank you, yes. And Loki, they're all, I mean, they're all facial scanned without a doubt. And they are pretty damn superb the way they're doing it. The way that Hasbro have managed to get that kind of, there's redness in that skin tone, there's blood on the face, there's eyebrows, there's tones under the eyes, there's a stubble going on there, there's a decent color of lips instead of that crazy ass kind of, you know, like we showed Luke last week with the kind of the pink lipstick he had on. So they're getting a lot better, but that is, again, if you want to pay, what is it roughly, about $40 maybe shipped US?
I think it's about $32 US.
$32 US. Plus shipping, I guess, maybe.
No, it includes the shipping.
Includes shipping? 32?
Yeah.
So 32 US if you want to get a Punisher. Yeah, but what a great job. He's just such a good customizer. What else have we got in the Marvel bits and pieces? Some other new figures went up for pre-order this week. They're not yet out at American retail, but an Australian e-tailer here, known for getting a lot of stuff from overseas in China, has them up for pre-order right now, coming November, December. The Hydra 2-pack. The one is a repack of before, and the other one is a kind of beefy remake, repaint of a different figure we've had in the past with Drax's rocket launcher. Kind of looks like the, his name escapes me. He had a kind of cyborg face. Anyway, in the Captain America wave. But good-looking figures. They'll sell like hotcakes. People just love these Hydra guys. The little Hydra logo. Very cool indeed. I meant to say to you, I don't think we talked about it. I went up last weekend to the Marvel exhibition. There's a Marvel exhibition on in Australia in a city called Brisbane. If you get a chance and you're coming up here before September, I'll try and share some photographs out on, got a little couple of videos as well, but what an exhibition.
This is the GOMA one?
This is the one at the GOMA. It's just outstanding. Tony Stark's racing car, a complete hall of armor. A life-size Hulkbuster, the entire throne room from Thor Ragnarok for Odin. God damn, this thing's amazing. Absolutely amazing. Every prop, every character, tons of weapons, and loads of other stuff that I've just skimmed over, but it's an amazing show, I kid you not. So I'll try and get a video up in the next couple of days. So if you're subscribed to watch Matt and I here on the 6-Inch Show, click the little bell or subscribe, and I'll make sure you get that little video, the video of the Marvel Museum exhibit, because it was awesome. I don't know where the cities is coming to. I'm sure it'll come to Sydney and Melbourne and overseas at some point, but don't miss it. It was really good. And the last thing I think we had Marvel here was, what do we have? There was one other thing to share, and that was some SH figure arts, which looked pretty good. Again, I'm not a big SH figure arts. I don't think you are either, really. We had this discussion before, but 6-inch Iron Man Mark 47 and Spider-Man Homecoming in his homemade suit looked pretty good. Not too shabby.
I think the Iron Mans look pretty good in these in this range. Spider-Man looks okay. I just get a bit iffy on him from time to time, but I think they really knocked the Iron Man.
They did, yeah.
Was out of the park.
Yeah, they've definitely got that down to pat. So if you want to pick them up, again, there's a link in the show notes there. You can get them there, the two of them together. Just convert that to US or UK, whatever you got, because they ship to the USA and the UK, I think Canada too. That's the Marvel-y and the Star Wars-y bit. I think we're, nope. I'm always speaking too soon. Just one other thing I should. It's actually gone now, but through the week, if you were quick, I retweeted out that Darkside Toys had both Thor and Loki together in a 2-pack for $25 US, which is an absolute steal for figures. But they come they're double packed in the cases, I believe, for Thor Ragnarok. So, this is why these guys had extras. But yeah, check them out, Darkside Toys, if you want to pick up some bargains. They've got a lot of older Legends as well for pretty cheap prices as well, from $8 for some pretty cool figures, actually. and some build-a-figure parts if you're looking for it. So you can get in there. They get some loose stuff as well too. You can check them out up there. 6-inch Marvel Legends loose. So check them out. We're done for that. Now comes two. And people really love this. I don't know what people had said to you, but I had great fun doing this last week. We talked about the history of the Black Series. And I think a lot of people like you and I were a little bit freaked out thinking it's nearly 6 years since the 6-inch line started. 6 years. It feels like yesterday. But we went back last time on episode 4 and we looked at the Sand Trooper. We looked at R2. We looked at Darth Maul, and we looked at Luke X-Wing. So I thought we could look on the next 4 figures in the wave, and we'll look at 5, 6, 7, and 8. And boy, oh boy, were there some crackers in this wave. So one of the first ones was Leia. We'll look in more detail at the pictures. Just a quick look at eBay just to see how prices are going. Do you remember when the guy... now, Slave Leia, this figure came out, this peg warmed. I think we talked about this before briefly, but if you remember the guy who, the dad in, I think it was New Jersey or something, complained about this. Do you remember hearing about that?
Yeah, I do. I remember hearing about it, and then there's all this talk about Disney having just bought Star Wars, that they were going to remove all reference from Slave Leia moving forward. No more fan art, no more images. It was going to be wiped, and overnight the peg warming stopped and the prices spiked.
I know. It was absolutely nuts. I remember the weekend it happened, and the next week happened to be at Comic-Con, and the same guys who'd been literally giving away Leia for like $10 was way up at like $60. It was absolutely nuts. Just shows you the power of getting that kind of news out there. But douchebag dad aside, stealing all the fun, she's actually gone back up to quite a pricey price. I'm going to kind of back down the way, but there's still a lot of her figure there up at $90. But I guess having passed away now, Carrie Fisher is probably more in demand for some action figures there. But yeah, we'll get a look at that figure in a minute. We'll go through the high res, the glam shots, and the actual shots of that in just a moment. Who could forget Boba Fett in the Black Series? I have to say, it's still probably my finest figure overall. I don't know about you, but my God, the Boba Fett in the Black Series is stunning. And he's been so good. We've had him in prototype version and his version where he came with the carbonite. But there's so many fakes on eBay as well. There's tons of fakes of Boba.
And most people don't complain about them.
I know, they're pretty good. They're really pretty good. Or they're seconds or whatever. But yeah, there's tons of them. But yes, you can see the prices that are way up, like $250 for some kind of graded ones. There's about $30. That's for prototype, which is not bad, actually. That's pretty reasonable for US price for prototype fit. Again, you don't know whether some are new or not. There's one at $25. So there's some fair prices out there. There's a Jar Jar Binks and carbonite. We've seen that a few times. So yeah, you can search around and look at Boba. And again, we'll look at that more in a minute. That is not Black Series, but never mind. So you've got to be careful on eBay. The other one we're going to look at is Greedo. I actually think this is one of the most underrated figures that... he was another peg warmer, wasn't he? He sat for ages and nobody really...
And so did the 2-pack as well. I remember the 2-pack was one which we got in Australia at Toys R Us, and it just sat there for years.
I know. What, if that thing had came out with a plastic table or plastic chairs, boom.
That was exactly what I was about to say. It's just a thing of the environment. It was cardboard repacking the two figures as opposed to what they're doing now.
Yep.
By giving you a scene kind of thing.
Who knows? 5 years' time, we may get a repack with plastic chairs or something like that. But we'll talk about Greedo as well in a second. And the last figure that we're going to talk about as well tonight is Han Solo, who's back out on his 40th anniversary card. But the previous one is still going for a lot of money on that original black and orange card. There's a couple of prototypes I noticed here tonight. We don't actually know if they're prototypes, but that's a... I had a look at this auction earlier on. Let's click through and have a look. It looks incredibly slouchy and old man there. Maybe that's just how I feel, these kind of saggy shoulders.
But, is that that's Force the Awakens?
Yeah, it's the Force Awakens one. I'm just showing it just for... But yeah, it's supposedly a prototype, but I mean, there's nothing really to stopping someone just making a 3D print and charging a $400 price tag on it. So you got to be careful. You just never know, because there's a few prototypes floating around here. So who knows? But yes, there's a few Han Solos in his black and orange. But again, he's still pretty pricey. He's still pretty, such a strong figure in demand. And again, for long enough, this figure was swinging on the pegs. I remember picking up all four of these figures. Bobas for $11. Han Solos for like $10. And just nobody was buying them.
I think, I don't know if we spoke about it in the show last week or you and I were talking, but I had like 4 or 5 or 6 Boba Fetts, and
yes,
I just kept giving them to people for birthday presents and Christmas presents. And I'm just like, what did I do?
I know.
Why did I do that?
They don't appreciate them. I think you were saying that.
They have no idea what they're holding on to.
You're holding on to the best Black Series figure ever, nearly. Is it the best Black Series figure? Leave a comment. Let us know what's your favorite figure in the Black Series line. I think probably Boba is going to be mine, just in terms of paint, and he looked great, and it's Boba, and I'm a Boba nut. But what is your favorite figure overall?
You know? Look, I go with the classic Stormtrooper and then add on Han and Luke. That's Stormtrooper disguise.
Stormtrooper that, trio.
Yeah, look, that Boba's there. The new Darth Vader's there. I don't know. He's definitely there. I just keep changing, but sentimentally, it's Luke and Han in Stormtrooper.
Nice. Good call. Okay, so let's get a look at this Black Series here again, just these original figures, and we'll kind of zoom in and show you some detail on them. But she came with a Force Pike, and she came with another kind of scythe weapon. I don't know the exact names, but the metal bikini that caused all the fuss. It really wasn't that bad a figure. I think a lot of people were just a bit negative on it, I think, at the time. Soft goods, nice detail, if I can say that sounds really pervy, but nice detail on the bra. I remember a lot of people at the time were talking about the chain and how they replaced it out for proper chain as such. And there was a little buzz on eBay as people ran out to get chains to put around their sleeve layers. I believe she was a little small from memory as well. Now that I look back at her, she is a little tiny. But then she was small anyway.
I think wasn't people's complaints that she was maybe the right size and that the
good point.
The Bush one was too big.
Maybe that's what it was. I think you're right. Yeah, I think you're right. Actually, that's right. I remember somebody put together the the two layers together, and I remember he lost his shit entirely about it, and it was just a little embarrassing for him. But there you go.
I have seen somebody, and it may have even been the old boys team, but they did an amazing repaint of this figure.
I'd love to get that, because when you look at these kooky-ass eyes, how things have changed over 6 years.
And my point of doing this thing that we're doing right now is people do, the amount of bashing that goes on is sometimes annoying, unjustified. There are some brilliant figures in the first waves, but figures like this too, which is a great figure, but you look at the head on this one, it's like, everyone's like, oh, remember how good they were. There was still some surprises. And this is one of those surprises, as far as head goes.
I know, eyes. I agree. It's not great. I have to say that kind of shot does not look as bad as many that I'd seen and have. That is a particularly bad shot. So I think there was maybe a little more finessing added to the eyes than that version there, but maybe I'm just being sentimental and I can't remember. But it is hard to do a naked lady with a bra on, essentially, figure. And
that many points of articulation.
I give them kudos for doing it. We got a slave layer. And I did like the kind of intricate details on it. And the two weapons looked good. And the chain wasn't bad. I think they did a very fair job, to be fair.
The only thing I would have changed with it, if we go, this is going to sound a little higher just about there, I would have got rid of that point of articulation on the thighs and just gone straight down to the knees.
Just gone straight down to the knees. Yeah, a good point. I agree with that. That would have increase the kind of design aspect of it there. But look, It's not a terrible figure. I certainly don't think it's the worst of the Black series, that's for sure. But again, leave a comment, folks. Let us know what you think. This is just Matt and I talking about it. So tell us what you think. There's a slightly different version with less googly eyes. Now, this was the glam shot they had. So you can see, it is a little different from the pack shot that we saw earlier on there, but much more matte paint on the figure. And a little bit more detail in the face, and very red lips. I think that was an issue as well. I always remember the lips were a little bit off-centered and a little weird. So, to his credit, Steve and the guys, again, certainly on Marvel Legends, but more so as we're about to see on Star Wars, the facial sculpts, I think, are really going to be the surprise of the middle of 2018 on. I think we're really going to be very, very happy with what we get, so... Yeah, it was not a great figure, but not the worst figure. However,
here we go.
What a stunner. It really was such a stunner. I think this was one of those figures that we mentioned the last time, that Boba Fett number 6 in the Black Series line. They just had so much love for the really went to town on it. They really, really went to town on this figure. Evidence, I think, by, and it's not quite in focus at the moment, but it is a high-res picture. Evidence by, I think, a lot of the detail that was on the body, the weathering, the kind of, for some reason, this isn't focused, the image is too big. Let me try a different picture there. There we go. The scrapes and scratches, all the dents, all the dings, all the silver on the figure. It was pretty stupendous. Even the helmet, we didn't need a removable helmet, and we just got exactly what we needed. The cape's a pain in the ass. It does certainly, even as you can see there on that glam shot, frays to hell. But, so how many did you end up with after all your gifts of Bobas?
Look, I think I've still got probably 3, maybe 4, plus the the Han Solo exclusive from back whenever it got released. I think 2000, was it? 13 or 14, I can't remember.
Yep. Well, we'll talk about that one. I think we'll chuck that one into the next time because, yes, Boba was re-released as a Celebration Europe exclusive and a San Diego Comic-Con exclusive, I think it was, at the time. I can't remember, was it 2 Celebrations or was it? No, it wasn't Celebration. There was no Celebration that year. It was Celebration Europe and San Diego Comic-Con, and I was in that queue at Celebration Europe trying to get that thing, and boy, was it mad. So, the siren's coming to take us away there. So,
yeah.
Talking too much toys. So that's Boba, just a stunning figure. And again, you can see there's not a great deal of difference between the final, this is the kind of pack shorts, so the ones that are there to sell the products. Got these braids, removable jetpack and lots of nice weathering down at the feet. Great looking blaster. Held it pretty well considering he was so bulky and had so much kind of crap on his armor and stuff. It was pretty damn good. A labor of love, I think, by Hasbro. But even the glam shot is, it's just the same.
Yeah.
It didn't deviate, did it? It kind of kept it.
It didn't. So what, we'll get a vintage card one of this, no doubt. If not, for Empire Strikes Back in between, given the, I guess the original figure was released early.
Yep.
But I'd love to see them, if they're not going to do it as a vintage figure, I'd love to see them do a Return of the Jedi one and just give everyone the chance who missed it.
Yeah. Look, I think, again, we talked about this, I think, but Hasbro would be, I think the word they used was off their meds if they didn't put this on a vintage card at some point.
Yeah.
Just money on the table. Really crazy. And then you do a foil-backed version, and then you do a prototype version, and then you do the Return of the Jedi version, as you said. And
then you do a version where the rocket fires.
Yep. So there's plenty of mileage in the Boba to be had. So, yeah, they'll do it again. They will do it again. Now, this was one that was really interesting. I don't know if you remember this. We briefly talked about that we would cover this. At one point, there was a lot of buzz because Entertainment Earth were doing all this, in my view, kind of over-marketing of this and over-hype at the time, but they were kind of pushing that they were the first ones to get a reveal for the next Black Series figure, and everybody thought it was going to be an exclusive, but it wasn't. Do you remember these shots?
No, I don't. I missed them at the time.
Dude, this was epic. Lots of shots here that we never really got again in any figure, really, from Hasbro. But they got some kind of shots there from the movie, Paul Blake, and there was a lady as well who played it. I guess she's maybe in different shots there. But look, different angles of Greedo to show you the differences. Then there was the kind of design shots. I've got them out of order there, or the final shots, I should say, looking very clean. He was a little bit more weathered than that. And there's the back of the pack. But what was interesting was these pictures. This was some of the design notes that Hasbro shared at the time, and they put them up at Entertainment Earth there. Again, is this exclusive reveal by them, even though they didn't have the exclusive figure. They had a kind of before and after, little tweaks they made. And what was really interesting, I thought, was you can see the design notes there that said, make fabric drapery more natural so that it only bunches up around areas near the joints. It's like almost the first draft digital design was then scale back there, little things to make the little details on the feet there. I won't read it all for time and brevity, but rather than a plain shoes, they added a little bit of functionality to it, a little detail. They added a trigger finger for the blaster. That was another little bit of detail they had going on there. So quite a difference to see all these little notes and the schematics and the behind the scenes. And this was another one, really detailed, not quite as big, so it was a little hard to share there, but I'll do my best. Altering the face. There's the original Greedo mask and rubber gloves. That was his hands, man. Can you believe that? Those were the days.
I've never seen these.
You never seen these pictures?
Nope, but I wish they'd do them now.
Yeah, I know. That's exactly it. But there's even an example. There was one ear down for Greedo, and they've come back and said, no, on this design, we want them match the head, larger skull, eyes further apart, blah, blah, all these tiny little details. And this is what they do for these figures. It's so easy to poo-poo them, but God, the love and the work that goes into these figures is something else. So there's the hand as well. They asked to make one of these incredibly long fingers bend around the blaster. And just lots and lots of different shots of Greedo there. Some really unusual shots that I've never really seen this one in the middle here. Little details, they'll add a seam into the design. Who would have thunk it? Add all pleated ribs should go all the way up the torso. Loads of little details, even little tiny little things on the blaster there. So very, very detailed kind of stuff, again, for a 6-inch figure. And I think that's what got everybody so hyped about this line as well, was the love and the detail that went into on his little crest as well. So, yeah, a pretty slick bunch of images. And again, we've not really seen them since that. It's a shame. We've seen little brief images of that for Kylo. This is a glam shot. Again, there's not a lot of weathering on this, but he does have weathering on the final version. You got to agree to, I'm sure.
Yeah, I do. Yeah,
you do. There we go. There's a more weathered, dirty version there in kind of high res. And you can see the difference it made to the jumpsuit because it was dirty. It wasn't clean in any way, but loads of detail in the stitching on the jacket. What do you think of the figure overall? Are you happy with this one?
Yeah, I was. Look, I was one of those who didn't rate it at first, maybe because I just wasn't ready for a Greedo figure, or thinking that Greedo wasn't really worthy of, figure number 7, that maybe should have come later down the line. And then the more I looked at it, it just grew on me. And then, after the fact, it was like, wow, that's actually one of the best figures.
It really is. I think, again, they just, looking at those images, they added such love and detail. And a couple of people told me last week that the once we'd shared some real images and spoke about it, they literally ran out to eBay and Amazon and picked up some of the figures we were talking about. So once the Greedo prices go up, as people suddenly go out and go, God, that is a good figure.
Really good photos.
He does, doesn't he? He really does. So yeah, if you're watching and you think Greedo's a good figure, let us know. Let us know what you think. Was Greedo good, bad? Give it a rating. Let us know what you think. But I really do think he's one of these figures that it's a great design. They poured a lot of love into it. And it's a good figure, a really good figure. So that was number 7 in the Black Series. And the last one that we're going to talk about tonight was Solo, Han Solo. I have to say, this has got to be one of my favorite figures in my top 5 for sure. What about you?
Yeah, I think he's great. I think again, it had all the accessories that we were hoping would continue, but this is that different hands, the holster, the Stormtrooper belt. It had it all. And again, lots of things in the past 6 months about this figure versus the SH Figure Arts one. And, you know, I don't know. I think SH Figure Arts obviously has more of a Hot Toys look and more of a Harrison Ford feel, but I think that the Black Series figure has a Han Solo feel, like, if that makes sense. One might look like Harrison Ford, who's always hard to capture anyway, but this figure is like, it embodies Han. You know it's Han, it looks like Han, it looks like Harrison. It's not movie realistic, but it's certainly a bit, like I said with the Luke's the other day, it's comic realistic, it's character realistic, it's video game realistic, it's all the versions of Han in one kind of thing. And again, I think they nailed it.
It really did. I think the one, and there's one thing we'll talk about just a sec, but there's the glam shot that we got of Han Solo at first, and the hair, the detail that's in the weathering in that hair, the blaster detail and effects on it, the jacket had a kind of matte effect and stitching that was kind of highlighted. The belt, oh boy, the belt. It's not often you get excited about a belt, but the leather and the weathering. I mean, again, this is one of the first figures. Boba had it a little bit. One of the first figures that really had all this detail and. It's just fantastic. I think some of the pouches there and all that kind of weathering they applied to that. We just didn't get that before. But for and there was dirt there as well. So you really, I mean, it caught the kind of swagger of Solo, I think. And there's the final release, which looks pretty much like the glam shot overall. Again, not really holding the blaster very well because it's in probably the wrong hand. So whoever's taking these photos, what are you doing? Anyway, the one thing I think I wanted to say about this was. This is one I don't think you'll really get again from Hasbro in the way that they don't do this very often, where you've got two Lukes in one pack, and I don't mean Luke Skywalker's, two different designs in one pack, because that's two cracks at the whip, really, isn't it? If you think about it, you've got the just classic Han Solo in a box, and then 3 years later release it as a Death Star escape pack. Because they did that in the vintage collection. They've done it numerous times in the saga collection. So it was kind of weird to get this in the one box. It was kind of like, wow, we're getting removable belts and swap out hands. And which again, I think was the first time in the line that this was the first time in the line that we'd had swap out hands, which, wow. I mean, for Star Wars, Marvel Legends have been doing it a little bit, but for Spideys, but this was quite a big deal, I think, at that point.
I think it was just, again, it was that thing, the first wave, they put all that love into making the best figures to launch the line. In the second wave, they did incredible figures with Greedo and Bobber, and then they got to Han. They totally spoiled us, but it was just to get this ball rolling on the fact that Black Series was the bomb.
It was. And on that bomby explosion, that's it. That's history of the Black Series Wave 2 as such. But we'll go through next week and we'll look more at the Boba with Han and Carbonite. And there's Luke, I think, and Obi-Wan and Stormtrooper and other some good stuff. So we'll talk about them on the next show. I love looking back at these old figures. I want to go back out and get them all out, play with them again and look at them again. And they're right. Such a good line. But again, let us know what you think, folks. Which ones did you like and of that little Wave 2 bunch? And we'll talk about it in the next show. Your cool stuff. You get some great stuff as usual. If you don't know, and I've not plugged enough because it deserves to be plugged because it is good toy porn and we don't get enough of it. Matt runs Star Wars, sorry, I keep saying Star Wars, Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries. And you're a fine curator, sir. You find a lot of great stuff. And I love looking at it. There's some really great pictures taken by stuff. I think the way you've curated, you've picked out some of the best ones, but kept it different and not just all the same, not just all troopers. You've got all sorts of different figures.
I try to, but I do fall victim of a number of trooper shots.
Well, that's allowed.
It's
That's
so
allowed.
good. I always try for
Troopers
something
look great.
else.
Troopers look great, but the one that caught my eye this week, it's one of my kind of picks. I thought I picked out your bunch, and there's thousands of them, so it's not as if we're only picking five here. I just randomly picked some. I had to almost double take at one point. This was taken by Chevy Tuhu, another crazy Instagram name. I almost had to double take that this wasn't toys.
Yeah.
it just for a moment had that scene, just that brief second scene you see where they're ripping the land speeder apart. That's fantastic. It's so good.
It's just the composition of it, though. It's kind of like you go, okay, it's a great shot. Everything works. You're looking as if you're looking at a scene from the film. The rock, the placement, the angle, everything is, yeah.
I agree. The rock is definitely, I remember that larger rock just there in the foreground, and they've got it really nice the way they've done it. In the last bit, yeah, they look fantastic. So they're very good figures, really. I think that the Sand People, Sand Person, Tusken Raider, why can't we call them Tusken Raiders? What the hell?
I don't know what's going on with that, because it still doesn't work for the singular.
It feels like a politically correct bullshit way that we have to now, you know, Tusken Raiders are real people now. They have feelings and all this kind of stuff. We have to call them Sand Persons, but there we go. So that's another cracking shot, and again by Chevy Tuhu. The other one, which again I just kind of picked out, which I thought was particularly good. Not that one. We'll come back to that one. But this one again was another kind of movie short, taken by Trippery, T-R-U-U-P-R-E-I. Wow, they've got the Death Star walls going on. I think the
the GDP toys, the space walls. And it just looks like one of those black and white set shots.
Yep, it really does. It's just beautifully done. 1977, man, and we're still posing our toys to look like they did there. And I think he's got an old boy CTTS head sculpt on that there. I'm not quite sure.
I can't quite see. If it's not theirs, it's somebody's, but it's definitely a custom.
It's not the original, but definitely a different cape as well. There's it's a much fuzzier looking, felty looking cape that he's got on, much heavier draped down him. And Vader there in the background. But just shows you, I hope this inspires people, if they get a chance to look at your account, to go do their own toy photography. Because you should. It's great fun, and it's really good fun to connect with other people, and I know it's built up a little community out there. So, God, there's such cool shorts. They're just so like the movies. I want to go play with some toys. Some other ones you had, Thrawn. There's a lot of Thrawn pictures out there right now, but just a great, proud pose there by Rebel_Jawa, and just the way he's managed to just pose Thrawn there in front of his Yaz Lamari, or whatever we call them, just looks great. Looks really good. Good pick. Nice and simple, really. I mean, not too much to be done there, I guess. Just going to pose it in front of the pack, I guess, the way they've got it displayed. But just shows you a bit of cropping. It looks good. This was another one, and you were talking about this here. This is from SWITT Picks. And I guess we're both, I thought the same, actually. Was this in Hawaii or something? They were obviously high up somewhere. They can get a picture in the clouds, but looking good.
I think he commented where he was, or was that via message? No, it was via message, but yeah, it was on the top of some mountain in Hawaii.
It was, oh, there you go, which isn't surprising. But yeah, really, really cool to see that biker scout there. And I think he's holding it looks like a sniper or sniper rifle in some ways as well. So yes, looking very good. I like that one a lot. And the other one I just randomly picked out, again, there's tons. There was this very moody, broody shot. Do love a silhouette. Always looks good. Of Boba.
Yeah, proto, apparently.
Oh, is it? There you go. I didn't even know.
I'm just having a look. Let's see. I think there might have been a comment there. There we go. Really appreciate. Got to love the proto. That proto fit.
Proto fit. There you go. By that's by Captain_Roswell. It's looking good, man. There's a lot of cool stuff on there. And again, if you haven't, you don't follow Matt, then what's wrong with you? Get out there. Instagram.com/StarWarsTheBlackSeries, and loads of cool pictures from Revan and Luke's and lightsabers and trippers and sand persons, people, whatever. I like the little touch there of the sand people with the Luke macro binoculars.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of people buying cheap Luke's here in Australia for like $11 and then giving it to the trippers. Even that, it's just a simple shot of the, you know, nothing too fancy going on there from Hayekel, just of the TIE fighter pilot. Great figure, actually. Another really underrated one we're getting again soon. But there's loads of this cool stuff as well with dirt and dust and maybe a little bit of composition going on there. But That's good stuff. And some custom sculpts for Kylo with his very bloody scar on his face. You get some good stuff. Any ones that you want to highlight or talk about that you can think of?
Look, you just went past a custom...
Nine Nun.
Yeah.
Nice. That's pretty good. How the hell did they do that? It looks like a bit of Solo belt.
Yep, and a Solo vest, I guess.
Yep. Custom head and something else. It's nice. From Three Lezzy. Very cool. That is quite nice, actually. That's a very...
Just having a look at myself, what else there was. Oh, that Wampa shot was not too bad.
Yeah.
And it's not active now, but on the Instagram stories there, originally it was the behind the scenes footage, and it was great. It's all done on grass with flour.
Oh wow, really?
Yeah, this is not a snow shot.
Wow, it's all done on grass.
On grass in the backyard and flour.
Bloody hell! There you go. That's epic. There you go, folks. Be inspired. Get and do that. Get your, steal your mum or your whatever bag of flour at the kitchen and go play in Hoth. So I love that he's just chucking the snowtroopers about there like literally ragdolls. Very, very nice. Love that stuff. Even that Obi-Wan, we'll talk about him next week. He really was a great figure. He just needed a little bit of a paint tune-up, and there you go. Boom.
Yeah.
It's a great-looking figure.
I think the other one, just maybe if we scroll down to the Han and Chewie custom repaint.
Always again with the Han and Chewies. That was a good one as well. Sorry, very briefly.
Yeah.
Just a little black and white shot, where that could, the difference that can make.
One more, there he is.
Oh, wow, there we go. Jeez. Chewie, we're home. Damn. God, look at the Chewie, the paintwork, the difference it's made to them.
Yeah.
Whoa, that's fantastic. That is from Mike Della Paz. I know that guy. We've talked about him before, I think. That's very cool indeed. What a difference that Han is, just with that little touch-up as well, the same as Chewie. The Chewie looks fantastic there.
Yeah.
Wow. A little bit of weathering in the fur, and boom, you got it. That's very slick indeed. Damn, this is good stuff. Wow. Any more? Anything else? No, I think that took us back to the previous show, I guess. We talked about there. But oh, the look. Come and get lost in lots of toy pornography and have a look at it. Check it out. Star Wars The Black Series on Instagram. Anything else happened for you this week you want to talk about, plug or shout out to somebody or something?
No, I don't think so. I think I'm pretty good.
All good. All right, that's it from us. Thank you for watching, subscribing, joining, following Matt, whatever it may be. Appreciate your comments. Keep them coming. Let us know what you think, what you want. We'll continue on with the history of the Black Series next week and any other news. We're getting closer to Force Friday. We should see more. Fingers crossed. Let us know what you want to see, but we'll be back soon with another show. So good night from me.
And good night from me.
See ya.